K-Billy Super Sounds of the 70s weekend just keeps on coming with this little ditty that reached up to 21 in May of 1970. The George Baker selection, Little Green Bag.
That's what it would be like if my life was a Quentin Tarantino film. You know, as soon as I find a DVD store, I'm so renting that out again. That was a great film. If by this point the Combine had burnt every copy of Reservoir Dogs, that's my incentive for rebellion. Anyway, time to get out of here before some parasite thinks it's a funny idea to lay eggs in my bladder. Hello there, convenient hole in the wall. And there's someone over here. Wow, I was kind of expecting a creepy middle-aged guy with a crop-cutter briefcase and a suit to be standing there. Oh well. Seems I'll have to work on that premonition. Cogs? Red light? Exploded hole in the door? What could this mean? Surrender your secrets! Oh hey, convenient hole in the wall too. You wouldn't happen to know a convenient hole in the wall, do you? Boy, I've really got to cut this sarcastic crap at some point. Wait, who the hell decided to go to town on this wall with a grenade launcher? Seriously? Anyway, from one hellhole to another, what trials shall await me? Anyway, let's see how to open this door. Wait, ah, damn, the window's all foggy, I can't see a goddamn thing. Seriously, don't people have to work down here? Or do their employees have to have the spatial awareness of a mole? Wait, there's no one down here. So this is why my torch has been backing up for the last 2 weeks. Right, man. Think. Wait, could this open the door? Well, I guess this is as good a time as any to start mashing random buttons. Wow, it worked. I am the Keymaster. Wait, what's that? Foreboding background musical string? Boy, I don't want to go through there. Let's try the other door. So logically, it should be the other two buttons. Yes! I'm metaphorically on fire! But I don't entirely trust this door. It seems too welcoming. Yeah, to any would-be ambushers, your face needs more cinder block. Right, one, two, BLACK! Oh, there's no one here. Nah, nothing in here except some useless crap on the shelves. All useless except a empty can of Dr. Pepper. Oh, and that's still crowbar. I've got my name all over it. Cinderblock or crowbar? An elementary question, dear Watson. Because unless I get the bright idea of dropping it in a smeltery furnace, the crowbar's going to last me a lot longer. And I don't want to walk around in a dark suit without something heavy to whack stuff with. But though I see no economical sense in equipping these things with goddamn bulletproof glass. Well, maybe bulletproof. Let's see if it's cinder block proof. Right, here we go. Oh, goddammit, you bloody lights. Load cannon 2, Winston. Wait, hang on. Better take cover behind this door. Don't want to repeat of that incident last Christmas. Only about 4 out of 12 people escaped that room alive. What, even these cinder block traps ruined my day? Ugh. That's Diablo cinder block. I'm going to try one of the other ones. Let's hope 4's my lucky number. Yeah. Cool. Something worked. Oh, I can live with that. Wow, I feel safer already. Wow, I can fall off anything now. Be it man, beast, or reaver. I mean, head crab. Got a good swing to it too. Looks like all those days of college spoon, refectory, fencing are all paying off. Now I'm almost confident enough to go through the door the omnipresent music was warning me away from. But I'll try this door first. And of course it's locked. But really, at this stage, do I expect anything less? Well, it seems this crowbar can't solve all my problems. And into another oppressive, foreboding place I go. Second time better be the charm. It's boarded up. This is a surefire sign from the universe that going this way is a bad idea. But it hasn't shown any viable intention, so screw you, universe. I'm going this way. Oh god, it stinks! It smells like something died and someone took their corpse, marinated it in a bath full of milk for about 20 hours, then used it to scrub down the inside of a cheese-infested boiler. And once again, the universe is determined to make me take the most indirect route possible. Wait, what's it? Oh man! What's this pouring into my shoes? Oh, these are brand new too! Oh god! To any persons responsible, you'll pay, my darlings. You'll all pay. I mean, Jesus, it smells like a concoction of Mountain Dew and radioactive residue. Then again, I wouldn't be surprised if soft drink companies were putting radioactive crap in our drinks, just to give that little extra edge. Wow, wonder who renovated this oppressive looking place. Are the KGB still into interior design? And could this place possibly need any more airlocked doors? No, not that way. As much as that could be sunlight, it could be the light of hell trying to tempt me into the eternal damnation of chocolate. Oh, keypad, this is worth a shot. Would it really be so hard just to leave a piece of paper under the mat? Let's see. So, let's see. Process of elimination. One. Oh, god damn it. If only I listened to my dad and become a locksmith. Okay. One, two! Cops may be idiots, but these doors are bloody geniuses. Okay, let's see. One, boom! This crowbar freaking rocks! Look there! See how many problems I can solve by just hitting it with half a meter of hard iron. Anyway, time to get my mind out of the gutter and my body out of the sewer, or as I like to call it, the most impractical hell I've ever witnessed. Oh, another mocking button challenge, is it? Everyone who worked down here must have had completed Professor Layton about 3 times on their entry applications. Okay, what the crap is this yellow stuff? It's like no Mountain Dew I've ever seen. Right, let's see. Ooh, bit of a tingling sensation in my fingers. Holy radiation poisoning, Batman! What the frick? Are people flushing down live uranium these days? If I get out of here only to find I now have arm cancer, I'm going to complain about this to no end. That'll show them, bastards. Anyway, the less time I spend near lethal radioactive substances, the better. Right, let's try this combination. Finally, a room that doesn't advertise doom like it's its freaking birthday. Whoa, an armoured suit? Oh yes! Time to ditch this dirty blue Demon boiler suit. Yeah, I'd kind of prefer to stop the bullets before they reach my internal organs. Whatever, I need it more. Whatever, I'm sure there's plenty more suits like this. Wait, Gordon? I swear I've heard that name somewhere. Somewhere around. Meh, I'm sure it's not important. Right, no one around? No one? Good. Another side note, that orange paint job is the shiz. I'm gonna look so badass. Though I think jet black's more practical, and uber cool. I mean, all the cool kids are doing it these days. Third Echelon, Rainbow Six, Linkin Park. Wait, hang on. Oh, never mind. I hope to God this thing's my size.
Voice system activated.
Oh crap, it talks. Oh god damn it, you freaking boots! You bastard! Finally, there you go. Meh, a bit tight around the crotch area, but otherwise it's fine. I'm sure I'll get used to the sensation of my testicles being gripped in an iron vice. I'll be sure to thank this Isaac K sometime. And what's this? An iPod port? Oh man, I freaking love this suit. Alright, time to sally on. Let's see what's behind door number 2. What the hell is that? Chlorine gas? Hev suit, I demand you solve this puzzle for me. Oh wait, oh it's got a gas mask. Oh, this will be useful. But even with this armoured suit and a crowbar, I really don't feel like going into another threatening room. That door literally has a neon sign saying, ominous, please sign a reception on it. Oh, let's see, switch this flashlight. Oh my god, that's going to be useful. Methinks, Hev suit, that we shall have a long, thriving friendship. At least the universe is offering me an alternative to this pitch black, threatening, gaping maw of a tunnel. Well, from the frying pan into, well, another frying pan with chlorine gas in it. What the hell is that sound? Is someone dying over there? Then again, you'd have to be a real idiot to step into a tunnel full of green looking. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Oh crap, the Frenchmen are attacking! Please don't collapse on me! Okay, I'm getting out of the bloody tunnel! You don't have to tell me twice! Wait, is that someone over there? I can't see, it's too dark. Hey! Is there someone over there? Can you tell me where the freak I am? Oh fine, I'm coming over! Holy zombie Jesus, what the hell is that thing? Stay back! I've got 2,000 songs and a crowbar, I'm not afraid to use them! Let me out, let me out, let me out! Let me out! Don't trap me in here with this thing! Let me out, you worthless piece of gas! I'll do it! I'll really do it! Gah! Get him with fire! Get him with fire! Die, 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 die! Oh crap! I'm hyperventilating! Make sure it's dead! Make sure it's dead! Right, calm yourself. Calm yourself. Time to get out of here. Eesh, don't come back to bite me on the ass. It's official, these sewers need to be cleansed with fire. That's it. Whatever I do in life, I will never become a sewer technician. A ladder? A real physical ladder? I'm not hallucinating this, am I? Right, foot on the rung? Yep, it's real. The men and women of the ladder industry are the national heroes. I'll forever respect you guys. And then God said, go towards the light, it's less likely to have zombies.